Hi friends, today we are going to solve largest permutation problem from the greedy algorithm part. The problem given problem statement states that you are given an unordered array of unique integer incrementing from 1. You can swap any two elements a limited number of times, determine the largest lexicographical value array that can be created by executing no more than limited number of swaps. We have a given array. So as the given array, one of the very important thing to remember is that the given array is incrementing from 1. So if the array length is, say, for example, 5, then the value would be 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. And it's similar. So there are no unordered array, means it will be unordered, but the values would be in sequence starting from 1. And the second thing is that we have to perform swaps to make sure that we have to perform a minimum number of swaps. For example, if you look at this problem, here the number of swaps possible is 1. So you just swap 1 and 4 and the resulting element would become this. This is a basic idea. For example, there could be a situation when the values are 4, 2, 3, and 1. Okay. So, and the number of swaps possible is k equal to 1. Then for the first element, we are checking that we are finding that the first element is at correct position. So no swaps is required. But here, there is a possibility of a swap to be made possible. So basically, we would swap 2 and 3. So this is the basic idea so that we get the maximum number possible. So we will start. But here, one thing we could do to improve our complexity, we could create a lookup table kind of a thing. I am creating a basic dictionary for storing the index position of an element. Array. Indices of array. This is a dictionary to remember. Is equal to I. So basically you are storing the indices value and their current position in the list. This is the basic idea. Here we would be creating a variable where I equal to 0 and the max element in the entire list. The reason for that is that it's been given that the values are incrementing from 1 and the maximum element possible for an n length array is basically would be n. So for example, in an array of length 5, the maximum length of an array, it does not matter whichever ordered it is present, would be basically 5. Because the values would be starting from 1 and it would be incrementing sequentially. So while we have done that, we'll create a while loop while k equal to 0. So k is the number of swaps that we have performed and max element should be greater than 1. So to get the max element index, we could use basic Python functionality, which would be array of index of max element. But as you could see in this problem, just check for the spellings. Okay, so as you could see in every iteration, it will have to go sequentially from 0 to n and have to find that element of the max element. So we should increase our complexity. Here we could do one thing. The reason for writing these indices was that we would basically check our dictionary for our key value pair and we would get the output. So here the time complexity, we are reducing the time complexity from big O of n to just big O of 1. Remember the problem I have told you, like for example, there could be a situation where max element should not be equal to array of I, then we would basically swap the position of those element. The current position with the maximum position and we have right now we are just swapping the values of ARR, but you have to also remember that we have our indices table present here, so we have to swap those values also. And we would be decrementing our, because we have performed one swap, so the number of swaps to remain to be performed would be minus the current minus one. So this is the basic idea, and we would decrease our max element value, because once the first step is done, for example, if the length of n 5, the max element is 5, for example, the first step is done, then the second max element would become 4. So this is the basic idea. So max element minus equal to 1, and we would be incrementing I plus equal to 1. And let's, okay, everything is wrong. Let's check. Okay, I just forgot to return the value. Let's run the code again. Okay, we made some mistake. Oops, big mistake. As you could see, it passed all the test cases. This problem is a bit complex to understand because I was trying with brute force approach. The test case number 15 was not passing. So for that reason, I have to create a lookup table where I'm storing the indices of all the elements present in that array. And after swapping, I will be basically swapping the in these S places also to to keep the order. So this is the basic idea. I would like you to go through this problem. I've seen many other problems, many other solutions like this, but those were like little bit more complex. This I think could be much more easier to understand for anybody. And as I always keep on saying, if you have a better solution, please comment below. Send me the links. If you want to contribute, join the Discord channel. And as always, thanks for watching and stay tuned. Have a nice day.